know our intent and our heart. And the horn is that he, there is no place on earth, no place that he cannot be, and that his perfection is beyond withstanding. It is amazing. It's a tremendous picture of Christ that's being painted in this chapter, isn't it? We saw the verses last week where he was referred to as all the hopes and dreams of Israel, as the Lion of Judah and the Root of David. He is the one who sacrificed made for one time and for all people. And he still bears the mark. But it is turned into glory. And he is the one whose all-conquering might will withstand and whose all-seeing eye and none can escape. Few passages of Jesus' scripture show the glory and the might of Jesus in this way. We think of Jesus so much as that meek teacher, as that one who would tell us to turn the other cheek. We think of Jesus as the one that says over and over and over, love one another as I have loved you. But now Jesus is in his glory. He is taking up his true role, the King of Glory. And then we enter into the choruses of praise. Do you know every hymn we sing has been inspired by these words? Singing new songs, new hymns, that we can find ways to worship and give God praise with our voice, with our very being. It comes in three ways, this great chorus of all of creation, because everything joins into it. You know, the verses Dog read from Isaiah, the verses we read from the Psalm, 148th Psalm this morning, all those things point to all of the universe, all of creation, singing and giving praise to the Lamb. It comes in three ways. First, there is the praise of the living creatures and the elders. Then, we have all the angels, myriads and myriads, thousands of thousands. And then we have every voice throughout all of creation, throughout all the universe, all singing in praise. Here is the amazing fact that heaven and earth and all that within them are designed for giving God praise. It is our privilege to lend our voices to this vast chorus, isn't it? It's an amazing thing that every time we sing, because let's face it, that chorus is incomplete every time there is one voice missing from it. And that is the sadness that we do not worship all in whole and in everything. But the time will come when we all do together, when we're all gathered around the throne of God. The praise rendered to the Lamb by the four living creatures and the elders is rendered because he died, because he was risen again. It's the song that's summed up in these amazing things that Jesus did. They speak of everything that Christ was. That he was a sacrificial death. That in the object of sacrifice is to restore the lost relationship between us and God. And it was for that purpose and with that result that Jesus Christ died. Now his death was an emancipating death. We are redeemed, not by human wealth, not by the things we do, but by the blood of the Lamb. The New Testament consistently declares throughout it that it cost the death of Jesus Christ to rescue us from the dilemma of sin and slavery to death, which had brought us to him. He frees us. He does it. The death of Christ was universal in its benefits. It was for men and women of every race, of every time, of every language. In Jesus, we meet a God who loves the world, not just individual peoples, not just tribes, not just people that live on this mountaintop or in this valley. But he loves us all. And it's the wonderful task that we get as part of the church to get to tell everyone about this goodness. Christ was an availing death. He did not die for nothing. He accomplished everything. And in his death, he not only makes us kings and priests, but he makes us sons and daughters of the living God, which gives us his triumph. And in Christ, there is victory over self, victory over sin, and victory over our circumstances. It's a wondrous place, and all this shouts to his glory. And that's what we get to join every time we sing a song of praise to Jesus Christ. We join their words, their unending hymn, their praise to his glory. Let us pray. Dearest Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for the opportunity that you give us to join in the chorus of praise. We give you thanks, we give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. We do ask, Lord, that you will help us to ever make that joyful noise to you, that you will help us to make that joyful noise and join in those choruses. For you are worthy, you are the one. We thank you, Jesus Christ, and we ask that you will be with us and in us. In Jesus' holy name we pray. Amen. As you know, we are not passing the offering plate at this time. They are in the back. You can place your offerings in as you come or as you go. If you are watching us on the TV here in town and would like to help with the mission and ministry, our address is Post Office Box 24, McClure, Ohio 43534. We always appreciate and use all gifts for the purposes intended. Let us pray. Dearest Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for placing your heart, your love upon our hearts. We thank you, Lord, for all the ways that you care for us and all the ways that you make life good around us. And we like being about what you are doing. We ask, Lord, that you do take our gifts, our tithes, our offerings, and us, and that you use us for your glory, for your good, for your blessings. Allow us to be a light to those around us. Allow us to be hope to those who are in despair. Allow us to be joy to those who know sorrow. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Praise God, praise you.
Christ be with you now and for all your days. Go forth in his peace. Amen.
Mercy, say, he's getting along.